changed India is about India attaining its true potential. The world recognizes India's potential. Now is the time to translate it into reality. It's about putting India on a high growth trajectory. My vision is that with strong political leadership, consensus for reforms, and focusing on creating a better future for the young generation will bring the desired change India is looking for. The drivers of change are most effective for us in India when it comes through collective wisdom. Good leadership is always in short supply. The Indian Leadership Council, with its varied experience and expertise, will bring in many suggestions, will bring in actionable ideas, and should be a think tank for India's future. The Leadership Council is a platform for leaders to learn from leaders, for leaders to make new leaders, to create new leaders, and for leaders to work collectively towards common goals. I think at the core of a leadership council like the Economic Times ILC, Indian Leadership Council, must be the emphasis on creating value-driven businesses. Mentoring has to focus on ethical leadership. Values, ethics, and culture cut across all sectors and spheres of work. Ethical leaders have a tremendous impact on how people in their organization behave and what their views are and what they achieve. For me, the key priority in India is undoubtedly job creation, particularly for the youth. As far as job creation is concerned, a country like India needs both skills and scale. India's future hinges strongly on its job creation strategies. The key challenge we have today is creating jobs locally, but being competitive globally. My view is that the greatest opportunity of creating jobs, fresh jobs for graduates, for the younger generation, is in the services sector. Services sector today contributes almost 65% of our GDP. And by services sector, it includes banking, financial services, IT, back office, tourism, travel, e-commerce, logistics, all these areas. There's enormous opportunity for us to create new jobs. To me, future leaders need to be able to understand the impact of current and potential geopolitical events on their businesses, and be able to take decisions and adapt or react accordingly. Leaders need to have a great deal of self-awareness, have an ability to build, have an ability to sustain a work culture of strong ethics and values, and above all, stay grounded and humble. More than ever before, leaders today are under immense scrutiny simply because access to information is available to each and every one. Culture in an organization is a collective concept. It's a shared belief system, and that is why it is so important in building sustainable organizations. In today's business environment, nationally and internationally, volatility is a given. Change happens very fast. Leaders have to be alert. Leaders have to be on their feet. Leaders have to be on the ball to take quicker decisions, to take harder decisions, and stand by the decisions they take. Some may go right, some may go wrong, but they should take the responsibility and act. Act decisively. That's the need of the hour.